Welcome to another video session of HackerLead. In this session, we demonstrate a different use case, creating a model from scratch, generating documentation, and performing forward engineering, leading to a MongoDB script, Mongoose schema, etc. Model, you will be entering properties and information at three levels. First, at the model level, which generally represents a database instance with several collections. Second, at the collection level, where you will define the structure of documents to be stored in each collection. And third, at the level of the fields that make up the document structure. You first start by filling metadata about the model you're about to create. You can accomplish most actions in the application in a number of different ways. Via the menu up top, or by clicking on a button in the toolbar, or by right-clicking in the central pane and choosing from the contextual menu. To create a new collection in the workspace, I just do a right click where I want to place the collection. And before I create the structure, I first enter metadata. Then when I double click on the collection box, a new tab opens up on top, where I can now define the attributes in the document. Typically in MongoDB, the first attribute will be an underscore ID field. I'll add here an object ID from the list of all the BSON data types that are possible, and enter the field name that I want to appear. As usual, there are several ways that an attribute can be added in the tree, either through the menu or through the toolbar, or by right-clicking and using the contextual menu to decide what field or attribute to be added. In the central pane, we notice that the tree view of the collection structure is now in construction. An entry is added in the object browser, and most importantly, a set of properties is available on the right-hand side. The properties in the pane on the right-hand side will change depending on the field type that is being chosen. So if I choose a numeric field, you will see here properties that are relating to the numeric aspect of the field, whereas if I choose a string type, it's going to be properties relating to the string nature of the field. All of the constraints created in the properties pane and supported by MongoDB version 3.2 and up will be used to dynamically generate the MongoDB script. For example, if I take a numeric field, say that it needs to be an integer between 100 and 1000, and a multiple of 5, here's the MongoDB script that will be generated using the aggregation pipeline syntax. After entering the properties, constraints, and sample data for all the fields in a collection, and doing the same for several collections, you now have a model for your database. Here are the different outputs of the HackerLead model. A printout of the main model diagram that you can print to PDF. Or the PDF documentation, You can also produce forward engineering of the JSON sample document or a JSON schema of that model you just created. You can also generate the MongoDB script for that model. And finally, you can also generate a Mongoose schema. Here's a Mongoose schema. That concludes our video session for today. Thank you for your attention.